been a long time coming, but I still think we need to hear that song.
What? Are we going? We're on right now?
We're on.
Okay.
But I think we need to hear the song. That would have been a really great transition right there. It's been a long time coming, but I think we need to hear this song.
What song? I don't need to wear the headphones, do I?
No.
All right.
The long build-up before the epic moment.
Skibbity boppa wee boppa scoobity doo. Pick up on TV.
Wow, very improvisational.
It's so appropriate that he hits me because he's just...
He's a little fucker, yeah.
Finally. I've seen so many Instagram comments. When are you going to do the Sean Ricany TCU TV? Sean Ricany is here, ladies and gentlemen. There you go.
Let's continue the thought that you were just expressing there. You were saying that your reputation went to shit, and then you had to work really hard to get it back to good, and that you didn't want to fuck it up again by coming on this show, right?
Yeah, so you guys been trying to get me on here.
Yeah.
And I knew that if I came on here, I could possibly say a bunch of things that people don't want to hear, but want to hear at the same time, but could fuck me over in the long run.
See, I feel like you're smart enough, though, to know what you shouldn't say.
Well, yeah.
But in his defense, the internet has tricked him so many times before.
Right. Yeah. And you guys are... I figured you guys would do the same.
No, we love Ricany, though. I don't even, like, regard you as having this negative reputation anymore. I feel like that was a couple years ago.
Yeah.
Do you? Do you feel like people
think
that
shit? Well, everyone judges me off when I was fucking 15 years old.
Right, because you've been in the spotlight for a long ass time, and you think that's one of the big reasons that you get...
Well, yeah, I was like, I did the TV show, both of them.
Yeah.
And like, people watch you grow up on that shit, you know what I mean? I did it for three years in a row, so I went 14, 15, 16. But it's like, all the people that are like, yo, this kid's a douchebag... It's like, realistically, what the fuck were you guys doing when you were 15, 16?
Totally.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So that's why people, like, they judge you off it, and it's like, yeah, now I'm 25 years later, and it's like, do you expect me to be the same person? You know what I mean? Like, people grow up and change and shit, you know?
I never seen the show. Have you seen it?
Yeah, I did. I was actually, I was on it one or two episodes, I think, with you.
Probably.
I think I came on with you. But that was always Sean, you know? It's always been little Sean, like, he's always... And I think Sean's always gotten a bad rap, too, because sometimes in BMX, it's hard. There's no blueprint, for one. There's no blueprint on how to be a pro. And everybody deals with it differently, you know? And Sean was certainly in a position where he got caught up way too fast and so much. You know, people saw the talent in him, but he's a young kid. He doesn't know, you know, when you're 14 or 15 or 16 years old.
But so do you think that you, like, maybe the general negative consensus at the time about you would be that you were just real arrogant and kind of stuck up and shit? Would you say that you were at a certain time that you kind of...
Yeah, I didn't really care about anything. You know what I mean? Because I didn't think, like, when I was 15, I wasn't thinking, like, long term or, like, this could mess up my whole... bike riding career.
But when you were
something.
15, did you understand, like, the position that you were in? Like, did you realize how big a deal it was to be on a TV show? Or you
kind of, but not really, because I wasn't used to it. I just didn't even think about it at the time. You know what I mean?
Right.
I was just, like, doing what I would have been doing if I wasn't on the TV show, kind of. You know what I mean? But it's just, like, when it's in the spotlight like that, it's, like, so much worse. You know what I mean?
Right.
And then, like, the TV show obviously doesn't, like, just show when you're sitting around acting like a normal human being.
Right, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They pinpoint out all the crazy stuff, and like, that's...
Was there a lot of crazy stuff on the show? Like, were there...
I was reckless as all hell.
Oh, so you really got the reputation.
Oh, yeah, he was the bad little camper.
Yeah.
What kind of stuff were you doing?
Just like, dude, I don't even know.
Masturbating?
No.
No?
Nothing.
That'd be
like
a weird episode, right?
Nothing like that, but just like, you know, it's just like, I would, like, take kids' suitcases and put them on top of the vert ramp and, like, just, like, all types of stupid stuff like that, you know what I mean?
That's funny, though. That's pretty... I appreciate that. That's just good old-fashioned hijinks. That's
yeah,
not
just,
like... You're,
just
you're not
basically
selling
just pissing just pissing everyone off.
Right.
And that's... He's still the same asshole.
Yeah,
he's
but I know who to do it around. I know...
But you've been hanging out with him a lot lately, so you would say that he definitely deserves the negative reputation.
No, I mean, he's just... You know, I think...
You live and you learn.
No, you're just... That's you. You know, like... people don't know how to take
but
it, I think.
The
and
thing
especially
is,
when it's in the context of Twitter,
right,
where you're
yeah,
saying
yeah, that's another
something.
Thing that really screwed me up.
I used to tweet
like I'm... Because, I was sitting in high school, like, sitting at a desk listening to an English teacher, and I was like, nah, let me cause some drama on Twitter.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I was just bored as hell, like...
And especially just, I think, the fact that you would, like, quote rap songs. You would just rap on there.
Yo, I
would. And you'd
be
saying the N-word.
Yeah. And I would, but I would never put, like, quotations. You know what I'm saying?
I would just
tweet it. And people were like, wow, this kid's crazy. And it's, like, literally. And then somebody would say something, and I'd be like, yeah, it's from this song.
Right. Yeah. Like, yeah. Come on. I mean, I used to do that shit too because back then.
Now
like,
I make
Twitter,
sure that I put it in quotes. Make sure.
And it's still weird if you say the N-word or some shit because even if it's a lyric, you gotta. That's kind of awkward. Yeah. But I don't know. Like, do you feel like? Well, let's talk about like obviously your main antagonist. Who hates you at Rodeo Peanut that gave you all that shit for
Dude,
a while
I,
there?
I don't know. And I went and like this is kind of crazy, but I went last, like, probably, like, say, like, 8 months ago, I went on my Instagram and blocked anybody that I possibly could have thought was doing it. So, like, just random, like, I'm not even going to say names because then they're going to be going into it. But I blocked probably, like, 15 people that I was like, these could be the people that are rodeo peanut at me. But I honestly don't care. I got, like, I, like, laughed at a bunch of them. There was, like, one that was kind of out of line.
Yeah, did they go over the line?
In one of them they did, but I'm not going to get into it. But they went out of line on, like, one. But other than that, they were funny, and I don't really care. But I just hate it. I just hate it because it could, like, I don't know who it is, and, like, I really don't care. Mm-hmm. But, like, I would just get the impression that I would be, like, around the people that were doing it at times.
Right.
And they would, like, shake my hand or say, what's up? And
that would be the worst.
And I'm like, yo, come on, dude. And I'm, like, there would be days we were out, like, riding, and I'm just, like, I'm, like, looking around, and I'm, like, I'm waiting for somebody to just take a photo or something, and I'm going to see it on Rodeo Peanut later.
You started to get paranoid?
No, not I didn't because I don't care.
Right.
See, but Sean's were the ones that sort of really upset me and kind of like turned me against Rodeo Peanut. Not that they're making fun of me, but I'm an easy target. When they started targeting Sean, they're on a stage and there's kids that follow Rodeo Peanut. They don't know like that's what Rodeo Peanut says is that's all right. This is the cool thing of BMX. They're making fun of some cool things. They're making fun of Ricany. Okay, now we don't like Ricany.
Right.
You know, and that's where I kind of had to draw the line because it's like if you want to hate somebody for having a personal issue, that's one thing. Or you want to make fun of somebody because they have they land in grass one time. But to like single a kid out that's you know. Not hurting anybody.
Yeah, I think it has a lot to do with like just being from the same area too.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I mean?
Ride different, you dress.
I ride different, like adjust different, I drive different cars, I ride skate parks and shit, and it's like
you got a big old dick.
No, I wish.
Yeah. But you know what I think was like the really, really funny one was when you did the tooth bar up the rail.
And then they put out that was good. See, like that
so
like that
funny,
stuff
yeah.
I laugh at and that stuff's funny. But there was other ones where I was like, nah, okay, cool. You guys got me. Great.
Yeah.
You know?
I mean, it is weird just when you think that when it felt like it was because I don't want to say that we live in a post rodeo peanut world because obviously they could just turn up the heat whenever they want.
Yeah.
But it feels like for a while there was like a reign of terror that was just crazy where every day there was a couple
a
of crazy
one,
things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I used to get hella comments on my posts that were just kids tagging Rodeo Peanut. And honestly,
really
I can honestly tell you,
I delete those.
I can honestly tell you that my block list on Instagram is probably over 5,000 people.
But you can't view your block list.
No, but I'm saying the amount of people that I block on a daily basis like is...
You'd
but
probably
it's the best thing...
If I unblocked everyone, I'd probably get to
the
100K that I want. Yeah, hell of a bad.
But it's the best thing to block people because like...
And then they message you on Snapchat. And
they'll
like,
message you
me,
or they'll like if you see like you get Rodeo Peanutted, and you'll look at the comments... And it's all the people that are talking
blocked.
Shit are dudes that have been blocked.
Right.
It's like you're so mad that you can't see his life, but you want to fucking comment and keep hating.
I have two such different mentalities, and I never know which one is like my real mentality where on one hand, I feel like I'll just let people say whatever the fuck they want. It's all good. I don't give a fuck. And on the other hand, it's like if you're going to say anything negative at all, I'm just going to delete you, block you, whatever.
Of course.
And I kind of go back and forth where sometimes I just like to let them live and sometimes I like to block people mercilessly.
So I like to go hard and give them something really to think about and then I block them.
Oh,
and
yeah, but that's you. Do you argue with kids? Like,
no.
That's what Catfish
not
does.
At all.
That's so
you
crazy.
Know, I actually learned from you know who 40 Ounce Van is?
Oh, yeah.
I like follow him on Twitter
him
and I just look at his tweets and I like learn hella shit from him. And one day he was like, he said something about like not catching him talking shit back on social media or something. And I just, since that day, I just haven't.
Yeah, that's a corny look.
Haven't entertained
you look
it.
Bad.
Yeah. But I used to entertain it.
Right.
Like I would go for hours back and forth. I was sitting in class, I would just back and forth.
I'll kill these
because you know that you can't win. There's absolutely
no
way to
no
ever
winning.
Win. No.
And then there's people that I've like had social media confrontations with that I've seen, and they just act like it didn't even happen.
Of course.
And yeah. I'm just like, oh, okay, I see. Like, not that I would even do anything, but I'm just like, like,
I mean, they're bored. Their lives are boring.
Yeah.
I know,
I mean,
what
I guess
my life
mine was at one point.
Yeah,
too.
Exactly. So I get it. You know, it's like,
yeah.
I get why they're bored, and I get that, like, the internet seems really serious, or like somebody who rides BMX that, like, you know, like the way that they wear their pants or whatever.
Yeah, the it pants just seems, thing, dude. People used
you
to.
You get that a lot, stuff. Huh? Yeah.
Now, if you notice, my pants are higher than they should be.
Why? Because your parenthood?
I went not at all. Chopping with him today.
No, not at all. I just changed. People change. People's styles change. You change. If I wore my pants like that for the rest of my life, I'd be bored as hell.
Hmm. Wearing your pants black man style was cool, though. I like that.
It was.
There was a few
bad.
Clips in there where your pants were fucking pretty low. It was pretty. Yeah.
Now
but
I wear,
hey, I like it.
Now I wear black pants cuffed up six times and they're too high.
Would you describe yourself as being just like into fashion or into clothes? Because, you know, a lot of times I feel like you're wearing something that is just kind of like a thing that's hip or a thing that's kind of in, where it's like you're wearing a fucking dad cap and a V-neck, but people in BMX don't really know. So
yeah, they
don't
understand.
They don't really get that that's just kind of like in style. So they're like, oh, it's a Sean Ricany thing. But
yeah,
it's just like a kind of like a hip LA
thing. It's a
thing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But, they,
thing.
But yeah, it's just judged differently. And like, I don't, I'm not like a fashion geek by mm-hmm. any sense, but you know what I mean? But like, I'll see like somebody that, like a rapper or something that I like am into, and like, I'll see something that they rock and they're usually like 10 steps ahead.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, and you can just look at it and you could just see like what is kind of coming in, and just like people that I talk to, like Steve-O, and like he knows a lot about like what's coming in and like mm-hmm. stuff like that. But, and like, obviously I started a brand and stuff, but like, I still don't know, dude. I'm still learning so much, and it's like, I'm clueless. In the big scheme of things, I'm still like clueless as fuck about fashion and stuff.
How you know? Serious do you take further? And how is it going so far?
I will speak on his behalf. When I went to his apartment for the first time, I was really impressed. Like, he's got a full-on, like, work area with, like, shelves and, like, to-do lists. Like,
like an elf. Like a little Keebler elf.
But it was, like, legit. Like, he's got his shit together. Like,
yeah.
Doesn't look like he's got his life together, but...
Yeah.
He doesn't? You're stereotyping.
No, I kind of... I mean, I kind of do. I try to, but... how serious do I take further? I would say it's like probably like if you were to put it on like a time scale. I'd... There
stupid
he is.
Ass dog.
Let me go check and see if that's the cops.
The dog is literally like barking at a bum or something. Just keep going.
But if you would say like how much time I put into it or whatever, I would give it like probably like I would give riding like 65% to 70%, and I put like 30% of my time into like trying to come up with new shit or like running around and picking shit up or like sending orders out and stuff. I try to, like, this is for the kids that are waiting for their shit for a couple of days, but like, I typically I'll let orders build up for like a week and then send them out at the end of the week rather, or like a couple a day or something, rather than like just trying to bang it all out at one time. You
right.
know what I mean? So like kids will email me and be like, yo, I haven't got like a shipping confirmation. And I'm like, yeah, because I've been out filming for the last 3 days. You
right.
know what I'm saying? I didn't have time to package up your shit.
Well, it's like,
but I try to normally...
They're used to dealing with Dan, so they're used
yeah.
to that 3 days
yeah,
shipping.
Yeah, I actually usually send like free, like an extra beanie or something.
Right.
You know what I mean? Just for the lag. But I put a decent amount of time, and like I search around for like new shit all the time. But like I said, I'm still like learning. And I don't have it organized properly.
Right.
You could say.
You're still learning about business.
Yeah, I'm just like
figuring. That's a real challenge.
I'm just like, I've only been doing it for like 7 months, but I'm like just still figuring everything out, you know.
Do you feel like you have a lot of like fans? Are there a lot of kids out there that fuck with you?
Like further wise or just
yeah,
me?
Yeah, further wise.
There's definitely, so when I first started it, I was like, I wasn't expecting a lot of orders, but I was like, yeah, I'll sell some shit. You know what
right.
I mean? The first like month, bro, I could tell you that I sold like probably, I probably had like 6 orders. In the whole first month.
Right.
You know what I mean? And I was just like, wow, is this the way it's going to keep going? You know what I mean? I didn't even really care, and I just kept it going. But now it's like it's picked up a bunch, and like I feel like once kids see other kids wearing it, that's when they vibe off it. And
kids are always going to hate on
it,
new
you know?
Brands, I feel like.
Yeah, yeah, totally.
As it gets older,
it's like
always...
it's kind of past the new brand stage.
Yeah,
I feel
yeah,
like,
yeah.
you know what I mean? It's not like, oh, this kid just came out with a T-shirt. Let's see how it goes. It's like I've been around for like 7-8 months, and it's like... People, like, there is kids out there wearing it. Like, you know what I mean? If you go to a jam, there's, like the Monster Jam. There was a couple kids wearing hats and T-shirts and shit, which I'm surprised at certain times because I'm like, whoa. You know what I mean? It's kind of weird
to see. I
feel
like kids might have gotten the weird idea about it, too, because it was kind of like a stage where like felt like everybody was starting a clothing company in
yeah.
L.A. Like, because
no, totally.
A bunch of our friends kind of Hoder took a little dip in, made a bunch of shirts.
Yeah,
and shit.
People just, some people committed and some people didn't, you know? And I didn't start Peep Game with Steve-O, but Steve-O had the Peep Game idea and that he did like a while back. And then he just like basically asked me, he was like, yo, you want to help me with this shit? You know, just like, we'll do it kind of together. And then shit kind of went, not like sour, but I was just like I felt like I could do my own thing kind of.
Yeah, what happened though? Yeah, is that falling out?
No, we're still good friends, you know? We didn't have any falling out, and I respect everything that he does, and, like, I learned a lot from him to, like, do what I do now, you know? But I wouldn't necessarily say there was a falling out. It was just we're, I don't know. Working together and being friends is, like, a whole different thing. I mean, we weren't even necessarily working together because I didn't even do anything.
Right.
I just was, like, wearing it and posting the shit up. But then, like, I was just like, I could basically do this with my own thing. You know what I mean? Right. And actually be more involved. And I wanted something that could take up my time. You know what I mean? Because, like, you can't ride 24-7 and stuff. So, like, in the morning, like, when people don't go out riding until 1 o'clock, I could wake up at 10, pack some shit up, like, search online for some stuff, you know what I mean? And, like, figure shit out. Rather than somebody else, like, actually doing all the work and all you are is just, like, an image or a face or, like, a promotion person or something, you know?
Why did you move to the OC?
Why did I move to Orange County?
From L.A., yeah.
I lived in LA for the last year and a couple months, and I like it. I like LA a lot, but it's just so hectic. Mm. You know what I mean? And like, I come from like Toms River. It's like a small town where you can pull up to the grocery store, park in the parking lot, and walk in. Right. Rather than in LA where you have to like deal with parking, deal with traffic, deal with this, deal with that. Plus, like, I was like, now that I'm doing this stuff with Colt and stuff, like, I was driving to Orange County to film with Vish all the time.
Right.
And like, I like to surf, and like, I have the dog, which is like way easier in Huntington Beach than it is in LA.
Right.
You know? And rent is just through the roof over here.
It is, you know? Huh?
Yeah. And I was living by myself for the last like, I'd say like 7 months or something. My girl moved out here and then she moved home. But
you guys are still together?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
But she moved home, so I was living by myself for the last 7 months, and it was like, it's cool and all, but it's like, I like Ben felt like I could have a roommate. You know what I mean? Yeah. So, and now I live with Vish in Huntington Beach. And
so you live with Vish?
Yeah, we got a 2-bedroom.
Very interesting. Living with the filmer.
Yeah.
That's a surefire way to get some clips, huh?
Ready for it? Yeah.
You're a fucking filming machine, though. Like, you put out like so many fucking crazy edits in the last year. You just go so hard. What is this?
I don't necessarily like. I'm not even trying to be like cocky or whatever. But like, I don't. Yeah, I guess I kind of go hard, but I feel like I could do like so much more because all the projects that I work on, I feel like are not necessarily rushed by any means, but. I would like to, for like, I have like an idea to film like some skate park video over the next couple months. But for like my next like actual video project, I want to take like 8 months to a year.
Right.
And like actually be able to like, so like my last video, like there was like 3 clips that I was like really hyped on.
The cult one.
The cult video, yeah. There was like 3 clips that I was like really hyped on, but I would like to like be able to go through a year's timeline and pick out the 20 clips that I'm really hyped on.
Right.
And put them out rather than having like filler shit and like, you know, not necessarily filler shit, but like shit that is like something that I did like third try or something.
But do you ride all the time, like every day?
Yeah. Yeah, definitely, 100%.
Is that practicing, or is that just like you don't know how to do anything else? You just want to ride.
I just don't know how to do anything else, and like since I've moved to Orange County, I've rode with Devin every day, and like not many people can just like go in a parking lot and ride for 2 hours and just have like the time of your life.
You know what I'm saying? Devin can do that.
Yeah,
together?
Like me and Devin can go and like backwards manual around the parking lot and like fuck around in a tennis court for hours and hours, and I'm like, that's what I love to do. You know what I mean? Because I came from a town with like no spots and we rode the basketball court all the time. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I love doing that, and that's when I always learn new shit when we're like joking around, and then it's like, oh, now I can actually do this on a real setup.
You and Devin riding a parking lot or anything together alone for like a couple hours sounds like scary. Like I can't even imagine
That's been my last week.
Yeah.
So you've seen this, a lot of this?
Every day. Yeah. We've been riding every day.
Jesus. Do you guys just feed off each other like crazy?
Yeah. Devin is obviously crazy with like all the backwards manuals and all that stuff. And then like there's, I don't know, we could just learn from each other, and like he's taught me a bunch of shit, and yeah, it's pretty tight.
Do you I don't know. I see you do so many fucking crazy things. Like that Stranger section in general had so many crazy tricks. But like one that stands out for me from the ride section was the switch 180 backwards, switch feeble, the fakie whip. Can you just tell me like what that day was like?
No, feeble.
Oh, feeble. That's what I meant. Yeah. Oh, it was pegs.
I did like switch 180 backwards pegs whip.
Right. Yeah. What is that? How do you just go and invent a trick like that?
I was sitting at the palace with like everyone was chilling at the palace, like Tony, Brenner, everyone. And Fernando was in town, and like nobody really wanted to ride that night.
Mm-hmm.
I'm pretty sure this is the case. I don't know for sure, but this is what I remember.
Is that usually the case at the palace or whatever? No, I know it's kind of disbanding now, but are you always the dude who wants to ride and like everybody else?
Not really, to be honest, no.
Because you don't smoke weed.
No, I don't smoke weed.
So that's why you have.
But no, that's definitely not the case. Everyone rides. Don't get me wrong, but like everyone also has the other thing that they do. You know what I'm saying? So like Tony and Brenner run the block.
Right.
And like et cetera, Dustin works or whatever, you know.
So you're one of the few dudes who's like just 100% pro rider and you have a clothing line, but
Yeah. But I won't say I'm like the one eager to ride because I don't like riding by myself ever.
Oh really?
You know what I mean, it's just like hella, it's boring, it's bland, you can't like vibe off anyone, you know what I mean? I like when somebody tries something and you're like, oh, we could try it together, or like somebody will do something and you'll be like, oh, let's do this. Or like, you know what I mean? Just like vibing off somebody.
I feel like you're so good that you probably just, being alone riding by yourself just gets boring because you don't want to just do this training.
Yeah, exactly.
Session, right?
Yeah, totally. And but back to the clip that you asked about.
Right, yeah.
Fernando was in town and like nobody wanted to do anything and they were just chilling on the couch. It was like 8 or 9 o'clock, I think. And he was like, let's just go pedal Wilshire. And I was like, all right, cool. And he just got like his brand new whale eye, fish eye.
Mm-hmm.
So he was like eager to film. And we were just like sessioning. And I was like, hey, you want to try to film this? And I was filming for the ride video. So I was like, yo, if we film any clips, are you down to send them to Zach? And he was like, yeah. I tried it for probably like, I didn't even like go there like trying to do that. You know what I mean? I was just like sessioning and I did like a couple switch 180 backwards grinds. And I actually just learned that trick like a couple days before that.
Mm-hmm.
Like I couldn't switch 180 backwards grind for the life of me. But we were like riding, just sessioning, and I was like, yo, you want to try to film this line? And I actually tried to do it differently. I tried to do hanger bar on the middle flat ledge and then do the switch 180 backwards grind whip on the last one. But it was like too tall and I kept like fucking up the switch 180, so I just settled with the hanger on the first one.
Right. This is just very confusing to me that you were able to invent this trick so casually.
Invent?
I think it's invent. Like I've never seen anybody do that on a flat ledge.
I don't know.
Maybe some weird guy in like Germany or something,
Russian or something. But so we just got the clip. We were getting kicked out and I like got it as a security dude was kicking us.
But do you ever feel freaked out that like a large percentage of the tricks that you do are things that you're like kind of inventing?
Not really. I mean, I did something like there's a couple things that like I would say, I didn't invent anything actually. I don't think
you don't feel like you.
What stands out in your mind is something that
get in the mic.
What stands out in your mind is something that you've done that's original or that you've
the only
never,
thing
you've
I've
never
done
seen
that,
before.
The only thing I've done that I think is like an NBD is a hanger bar down a rail.
Right, but now people do that, but you were
down
the first one to do that?
Down a rail.
Down a rail. I guess you're, but you did like the crazy-ass gap tooth bar.
Where?
You never even seen Garrett do that?
Down a rail?
Yeah.
I don't know. Garrett was the first one to do hanger bar, I think.
On a flat rail or something?
He did the hanger 180 bar on the out rail in like North Carolina like when I was like 15. And
yeah,
I was
like that's
fuck.
What I'm... Yeah, that's
yeah, so that,
why
like,
I would just assume that
but
he could do that.
I don't know. I've just never seen anybody do it down a handrail before.
Yeah. And you did a crazy-ass gap-to-tooth bar at Hollywood High.
Kind of. That's whatever.
What?
It's out rail.
That's not a big gap rail?
Not really. Kind of. I mean,
I guess. It's pretty fucking... You're going pretty fucking...
Another thing is, like, I don't ever, like, I'm not the type of person that, like, sees a spot and then, like, goes home and doesn't do anything and then, like, I'm like, all right, I want to go to this spot to do this.
You don't get worked
don't
up. You're not on
no,
mission.
No, I just don't do that at all. I don't really, like, say, like, all right, I'm going to go... I want to go to this spot to do this trick.
Mm-hmm.
Like, when I film stuff, I'm usually just, like, happen to be there and I'm like, all right, let's try to get this. You know what I mean? Because... When I do that, like, if I'm like, all right, let's go here and film this, it, like, fucks with me. And the whole way there, I'm like, all right, I'm going there to do this. And it just doesn't work.
You more about the vibe? Just, like, you want to be out
like,
sessioning and just make some shit happen
when
you
like,
feel it?
Like, if... So, like, for example, like, recently, like, Dak helped, like, with a lot of spots and shit for my cult video.
Mm-hmm.
And it's good because everyone, like going out with somebody like Dak and, like, Andrew and Grant and stuff, like... We'll go to a spot and everyone will just like take their bikes out and like grind the ledge and like feel everything out and then somebody will be like, all right, I'm gonna try this.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I hate when you go to a spot and everyone just kind of sits around and they're like waiting for you, like, all right, you gonna do something?
Yeah, that's
a
shitty vibe.
And I like can't do that.
Few people can like really fight through
that. There's like very few times that I do that and it's like only in situations that I feel like I kind of have to, you know what I mean? Like in an awkward situation with an awkward person or something, I don't know.
You know what really stood out to me too, as long as we're just talking about tricks, is that at that same spot on Wilshire where you did the 180 pegs fakey whip, is that you did like ice hop up manual, keep manualing, and then you just do bar Smith on a fucking tall ass ledge out of a manual, and that's not something I really seen before.
Yeah, I don't know. That's
did that occur to you at the time that that was crazy?
No,
no.
I put it on Instagram.
I know you did. That's why I'm like, what the fuck?
I did something last night that I like take hella pride in that I can't tell you guys, but
you did tell me.
I definitely, yeah.
You told us.
That will come out soon.
That's a very good trick.
There's a bar spin in it.
There's a bar
spin and some other stuff. All right, so let's talk about like various sponsors that you've left over the years. Like, what happened back in the day with Red Bull, Osiris, or what was the original one? Was Red Bull and Premium at the same time?
No, it was all of them in 1 month.
And why? What happened?
I went through like this period of time in senior year where I was just like kind of going to like high school parties and like not really riding as much, you know? I was like more caught up in like hanging out with girls.
But you were still riding pretty good at that time, but this is like before.
I didn't ever like lose it.
You didn't have the reputation that you have now of being one of the best riders.
Yeah, totally. I was just like there, you know what I mean? Like,
you were killing it, but
like
not
the Red Bull thing and all that like walked into my life, I feel like, from the TV shit.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
It was just like, oh, this kid's young and popular, you know what I mean? And that's why like the Red Bull shit happened. Bro, like the Red Bull thing, it wasn't even like deserved, to be honest. Like I didn't deserve to be on Red Bull when I was 14. You know what I mean? Like that was just like kind of like or 15, whatever.
But did you not know that at the time?
I didn't even care, really, to be honest. I was just like, whatever.
Because you don't know anything about the BMX industry.
Yeah, I was just like, I get to wear a Red Bull hat. Like, and all these people that are cool as fuck wear these, so now I'm cool as fuck. You know what I mean? And I was just like, whatever. But, I went through a stage in, like, senior year where I didn't ride as much. I didn't care. I didn't communicate with anyone. Like, I mean, I did not necessarily.
You're on Red Bull at the time? Yeah. You're in high school?
Yeah, so I looked like a badass with a Red Bull hat on.
What kind of money are we talking?
Not as much as everyone thinks, but really? I was definitely doing really good for being in high school.
Right.
Yeah. I mean, like,
give me some numbers.
No.
toss a number. Give me a Red Bull number.
What's Red Bull? A couple grand?
No.
Couple. Not grand? Even that.
No.
Really?
10 grand.
I turn for the year.
Yeah.
No, I'm not answering. Hell no.
No, but I know dudes who are on like Rockstar for a G a month or
a thousand,
whatever.
A thousand a month.
Like, I'm not gonna get into
you're not on them anymore.
I know, but
you're never gonna get on them again.
I know. But I'm not gonna get into numbers, but I was doing with all my sponsors, at one time I had Red Bull, Premium, Osiris, Kenda, Blenders Eyewear, and I think that's it. But it was like all paying sponsors. You know what I mean? And I was
so that's in my head, that's at least 5 G's a month.
Give or take.
But I was a senior
in high school.
But did you not give a shit? Did you think whatever this is going to last me?
Yeah, I would get checks and just spend them the same day I got them.
Like, what kind of stuff? Money?
I would go to the mall and buy like Louis Vuitton belts and like fucking,
of
fucking
course cheap he's key. Jersey. He's $400
sunglasses and just like
hair
just, like,
gel and
shit that I could
tanning
like,
bulbs.
Just dumb shit.
But you fully thought it was gonna last till you were 40.
Yeah, bro,
right?
I thought the money was only gonna grow.
I thought the money was only gonna grow.
I was just like, I was 17 years old. I drove a Mercedes and bought whatever the fuck I wanted. Of course I thought the money was gonna grow, you know what I mean?
Wow, yeah.
And obviously the reality check came quick. But
were you devastated when all the sponsors dropped?
I was devastated when he got.
I mean,
when he lost
the only thing, the
Red
only
Bull.
Thing, I wasn't necessarily. I was more so like, wow, I'm the only dumbass that got dropped from Red Bull.
Right.
It happened to Sean White too, so don't feel bad.
But you realized how big a deal that was and how unique it was that you.
I feel like other people cared more than I did.
Right. But you didn't really care, but you knew what everybody else was thinking.
Yeah. What did Red Bull tell you? What did they tell you?
They told me that their budget was no longer like, some budget issue. And my contract
was up.
It's
always a budget
issue.
They always hit you with the budget issue, but
it's a budget issue because we don't like you and we want to save a little bit of money on our budget.
I didn't communicate well with the dude that I dealt with, and he was a super nice guy. His name's Jenner. Nice ass dude. I did like a few random photo shoots with Edwin over a 3-year period of time, and that was it.
Right.
You know what I mean? And I like wore the hat here and there, went to the contest, wore the hat, blah, blah, blah. But I didn't do anything else, you know? And Premium, I was just kind of a dickhead.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I wasn't the coolest person to deal with on trips and, like, just talk to in general. And that was that. Kenda just like dropped their BMX program. Josh Harrington got me. I think Josh or Colin McKay got me on Kenda. And then like when that happened, me and Josh both got dropped, I believe.
Oh.
And then Osiris dropped me and the rest of their BMX
Everybody
program.
Else, right, yeah.
Yeah. I wrote for Primo too.
Right.
So like that was the other one that I was looking for before. But I wrote for Primo too, and the dude Johnny. Whatever, Rich.
John Richards. Yeah,
John Rich put me on, and I was like, it was mad funny. I was actually in the car with Steve-O, and I was like, yo, should I ride for Primo? And he was like, yeah, tell him put me on too. And I was like, word, all right. And then I was like, yo, Johnny Rich, okay, yeah, I'll ride for Primo. This is what I want, and you got to put Steve-O on too. And he was just like, okay, cool. And I was like, all right, word, clink.
That motherfucker was saying yes to everything.
Yeah, and then I never heard from him again. Yeah, I mean, I literally just got the checks every month. Road Primo shit, filmed a fucking welcome edit in 30 minutes at the skate park.
Yeah.
And that was it.
There were a bunch of people who were rocking with
Brenner,
that. Yeah.
And then Brenner called me the same month that I got dropped from everything else, and he's like, yo, I'm sorry, dude, but we're cutting your check in half. And I was like, tight. So my last check just got cut in half.
So were you devastated, or were you just whatever?
I was just bummed that I went from making like a lot of money to I went from making not a lot, but a decent chunk of change to $200 a month.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, like, lost everything.
And did you feel like, oh, I fucked up, I deserve this? Or were you just
no,
like...
No, because I knew I was going to come back.
Really?
That's
okay.
My man. Yeah. That's my man. That's what's
so
up.
So it motivated
because
I knew I was going to come back.
I'm not going to lie. Never, like, there was never a time where I hopped on my bike and I was like, yeah, I don't still got this.
But you know what I mean? So like, all that shit happens. Does that motivate you? Like, I'm going to fucking kill it?
Right now?
No, at the time.
At the time,
because
yeah,
you
yeah,
stepped
yeah.
it up like crazy
Brenner,
in response to all that.
So Aaron Brenner, shout out to Aaron Brenner. He basically put me back on the map, I would say, honestly. He put me on Stranger. I was on Primo, and he put me on Stranger. And that Primo video, me and Brenner, that was like one of the only times that wasn't, well, like filming-wise, where I would go out with just one dude
right.
and get five clips in one day
mm-hmm.
with like no chill session, no like people feeling shit out.
Right.
Like we just went to the spot, banged shit out, and left.
Because
you know what I mean?
Just...
Because I was just like, yeah, I need to...
You knew you had something
this.
To prove?
Yeah, like I need to do this right now. And just like too many people were talking shit, and like I feel like people didn't like, not necessarily not know like that I was capable of filming a real project or something, you know? They were like, yeah, he films all these dumbass fucking skate park videos and he has all this shit. Like, yeah, I would probably hate
No, but people shit. Definitely at the time didn't think of you as this dude who was going to film a section like your Stranger section.
Yeah, but yeah.
Just going in.
I just went for
it. So then, like, you kind of built your whole, like, name back up through Stranger and Primo and everything, wouldn't you say? Like, you were going pretty hard with them for a while.
Yeah, well, that was more so because of Aaron and the team, like Augie, Gabe, Miles, Eric, and the rest, you know what I mean?
Right.
Like, those were my close friends. Like, Augie's been my homie forever, you mm-hmm. know, Miles has been my homie forever. And, like, it was just like when we were going on trips, it was like seriously some of the funnest times. And just like everybody, we would go out in the van like probably like four times a week and just go film. You
right.
know I mean? And it was like super fun and shit. Like, at the time, I didn't even think about anything besides just having fun and filming shit, you know?
Right.
And then when Brenner left tip, everything, it didn't necessarily go like sour or anything, but it was just
kind of nothing.
It wasn't anything anymore. Yeah. It was just like, well, okay, well, here's your bike and here's your check, you know what I mean? And it was like, oh, you want a video every couple months, Instagram video, cool, you know? And which there's nothing wrong with that, but that's just not what
you weren't as excited.
I wasn't psyched, you know what I mean? And like now that I ride for Colt and shit, like I'm just like hyped as fuck to be able to like be in a crew of people that like I genuinely like, and like Robbie is like I can literally sit like and just bullshit with him for hours, you know
right.
what I mean? And like we can laugh like a motherfucker about shit that we both find is funny, and like, you know,
I still want to like, follow up on this though. When you chose to leave Stranger, what was the one thing that the straw that broke the camel's back? Was it LZ? Do you hate
no,
LZ?
No, not at
people
all.
I always want to know this.
No, I don't hate LZ at all. He like, I actually don't like him now. But
why?
Just because he tweeted some arrogant shit about me. Like, he mocked what I said when I quit.
Oh, really?
And put it on Instagram, like screenshot of like a note
oh,
like,
yeah,
on his
yeah,
phone,
yeah.
and was like, so as of today, I'm officially going to the grocery store to get eggs or some
right.
dumbass shit.
He asked me if he should post that, and I told him it was funny.
Yeah, see, exactly. So, like, you found it was funny, but like I already was edgy about him to begin with, and then he did that. Like, if I already, like, I wasn't edgy, but I was just like, yo, but you're just whatever to me.
Right.
And then he did that, and I was like, yeah, fuck you.
But so was you quitting
Adam's
was more
fault.
Just
that's
like
a... That's this Adam's fault.
But quitting Stranger had nothing to do with Adam LZ. It had to do with the whole vibe and another person that helps run the brand that just wasn't, I would say, as appreciative as he could have been, or like making me feel like I was important in any type of way.
Right. It's very important to be able to make a rider feel like they appreciate
it. Yeah, I did.
Because
I just
in BMX, nobody's
like
making that much money.
I constantly felt like people think that I could be easily replaced.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And like, oh yeah, we can just get rid of him and put this person on. Like, I don't like that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And like, I literally went from like that to like Colt being the complete opposite, where
right.
it's like,
so when did this even become an option or even a possibility of you being on Cult?
I don't even know, dude. So when I put it in my head that I was quitting, Andrew like always bullshitted like, yo, you should just ride for Cult. You should just ride for Cult.
Andrew Cast.
Andrew Castaneda, yeah, shout out to Andrew. Always just like, we would just be at the skate park and he'd be like, yo, it'd be tight as fuck if you ride for Cult. You know what I mean? And I was just like, yeah, it'll never happen. You know what I mean? And then, like, when I was like, fuck, dude, I'm not psyched on Stranger. And I, like, looked, I just, like, not looked around, but I just, like, thought in my head, I was like, what brands would I ever ride for? And what brands would not fuck with me? And,
yeah.
And then I was just like, Robbie's the only person that I, like, genuinely bullshitted with. And, like, honestly, if I was to pick any brand, I'd pick Cole anyways.
Right.
Just because, like, I like their shit. I like, the whole vibe of the place. I like
team.
The team. Yeah. And, yeah, just, like...
So what was this process like, though? Because I think everybody was surprised because there's a bunch of old school dudes on the team that everybody would kind of assume maybe would not want you, this, like...
Yeah, yeah.
How old are you right now?
20.
20. That's fucking... That's what...
He just got his ID taken last...
Yeah, because I've been to the bar with you like 800 times. That's funny. But then just the fact that you're this good and that you've, like... You seem like you've been around for, you know, as long
ever,
as I
yeah,
can
people
remember.
People think that
yeah.
I'm, like, hella older than I am.
Yeah.
It's not, but yeah. But yeah, you were saying something.
I think everybody probably would have thought like, oh, like fucking Dakota or Chase Hawk or whatever.
Yeah,
like they're not gonna be.
I can see Chase not liking
Chase DeHart's from Jersey.
No,
right?
Chase Hawk.
Yeah, yeah, he's because those are the dudes who started Cole. Like,
yeah,
yeah,
I can see Chase
totally.
Being salty.
And I have nothing but respect for that because it's just like being passed through that name of people and like eventually being accepted. You know what
right.
I mean, not yeah, I'm not necessarily. I'm sure there's people that are still iffy about me, you know mm-hmm. what I mean? But, like, they genuinely gave Robbie the okay to put me on,
right.
you know what I mean? And I appreciate that, and it just makes it feel 10 times cooler than just, yo, Leo, come on. It just makes it feel a lot cooler than just, like, being like, oh, yeah, you're on this company. You know what
right.
I mean? Cool, like, you know what I mean? And, like, it's just sick, because hopefully, actually, probably will, but if Robbie ever puts somebody on, I'll be asked for the first time ever.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, I've never been asked, like, are you cool with this person being on the team, ever in
right.
my life. You know what I mean? And, like, when, sort of example, like, when LZ was put on, like, nobody was asked or informed.
Right.
And that was just, like, what the fuck? Like, I was just getting texts, like, LZ's on Stranger, and I was like, what the fuck are
you
talking
about? It's a weird
way
to find out, huh?
You know what I mean? And I was just like, and like that type of shit isn't really that cool to me. And I honestly don't really care about that, but like, it's not cool. You know
yeah.
what I mean? Like, I don't care that somebody's put on the team, but just like, at like the somebody respecting you enough to ask, like, means a lot. You know
right.
what I mean?
What about, like, you and Dakota? Because you guys are both, like, riders. Like, you guys really like to ride. Like, he fucking
yeah.
rides the street like crazy. Do you guys
yeah.
get along well?
Yeah, I've been riding with Dakota a bunch lately, and, yeah, it's styled as fuck. You know what I mean? We ride, film. He filmed, like, a lot of clips in my Cult video.
Wow. Jesus Christ. Somebody you got to ask him about this. Oh, he's gone. It's host chat.
Host chat. So, Adam, how's your dick been?
Oh, my God. My dick. Well, I'm single. I'll just throw that out.
You're single. Single, ready to jingle.
Pringle.
Single and ready to
I'm pringling.
Get the Pringle
I'm pringling, baby.
So, ladies out there, Adam 22 is single.
But I haven't done, like, a lot of the, like... Oh, yeah, you're great. This is sick. Yeah, this is perfect.
You,
perfect.
You're
perfect.
All stressing. You thought Adam was going to give you the
I haven't done any
questions.
Of the single things, like, download Tinder yet, though.
Me?
No, you should do that.
Because I'm still hanging out with her. I just told her. I'm like, I'm not trying to be a boyfriend.
This is L.A. You've got stunning blue eyes. You got the neck tats. You shouldn't have a problem scooping.
How far in are we?
We are about 40 minutes in.
Oh, my God. I only wanted 30 minutes.
See?
I really am kind of a swordsman, though. You're right.
See? Yeah. All right, let's get this rolling.
Okay, so, yeah, Ryan with Dakota. Is that what we're talking about?
Yeah, Ryan with Dakota is dope as fuck. He's one of the best riders in the world. Yeah, it's just, like, easy to feed off him. And if, like, if I could pinpoint anyone as a professional bike rider, right, an all-around athlete, I would say Dakota, because he's got all his own spots. He comes prepared everywhere. He's always, like, it's just...
Takes his health very serious.
Health, like, all that. You know what I mean? Just, he's all around, like, a professional athlete. Yeah. You know what I mean? Rather than some people that are just like, oh, yeah, smoke blunts, fucking go right spot, you know? Yeah. It's, like, it's a real thing. You know what I mean? It's, like, his job and his shit, and he takes it seriously, and I feel like that's the way I would like to take it. You know what I mean?
Why don't you smoke blunts?
Not a weed thing? I just get paranoid.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm just, like... I, like, used to try to smoke weed in high school all the time and would get paranoid and shit. I'll take a hit of something before I go to sleep or something here and there, you know? But
PCP.
Talk to us. Talk to us. I want to know about Baby Sean, the beginning. How did you get started riding?
How did I get started riding? Yeah, fuck that. But my stepdad brought me to the skate park when I was, like, four.
What skate park?
Four or five. Incline Club, Scotty's Park.
Oh, so that's where it all began, huh? Yeah. And you still love riding it when you go back.
Yeah, I have hella fun there. It's just like I learned everything I know there, you know?
Yeah.
And it was basically like a daycare almost. But it wasn't like a daycare because my mom didn't like want to drop me off there. I wanted to get dropped off. You know what I'm saying?
So
I was
making,
like,
yo, mom, take me to the skate park. You're super young.
Yeah. Basically, I was just like, yo, take me to the skate park. And that's like all I knew. And like growing up all through school, people were like, oh yeah, you ride bikes, blah, blah, cool, cool. And then like all through high school, people, like, my grades always sucked. And mm-hmm. I was like late to school all the time, my far away. No. I was like late to school all the time. Like, as soon as I got a license, I would roll into school at like 9:30, 9 o'clock. You know what I mean? Like just whenever I wanted. And people were like, what are you going to do? And I was just like, I'm going to move to Cali when I graduate. And they were just like, yeah, okay. You know what I mean? Like, you're dreaming. And then, so I did summer school classes senior year. I had some tutor come to my house, and I took English and math.
Was she hot?
It was a dude.
Was he hot?
Was he hot?
No.
What was his dick?
Big, fat dude. His name is Brian.
Fat guys, fuck you, their Brian. Dicks are usually kind of
and
small.
And he did,
yeah.
He did like, I'd say like 90.
That was hella gay. Why
90, you 90 he did like 98% of the work.
Really?
Yeah. And wow. I just would sit there. That's on a hell my phone of a tutor. Shit, you know?
I didn't know that was how tutors worked. I would have got one.
My mom paid him hella money.
Really?
Yeah.
Jeez. You a rich kid?
Yeah. No, not necessarily. I wouldn't say we're not rich by any means. You know what I mean? We're my family. My mom is remarried to my stepdad, and my mom does not work, and he works.
What's he doing?
I'm not. He does something with like computer software, and he's
a
been
hacker.
Sounds like
no,
like,
no. He does
sounds
like
the Italian mob.
No, not at all. He's always like supported me like growing up with what I wanted to do, and he always like believed that I could be something. You know what I mean? And he supported me. He helped out with the ramps in the backyard. Premium helped out with the ramps in the backyard.
Right.
And my mom was always super cool. But back to the rich. Rich, no.
No.
I mean, we're like middle class. You know what I mean? We just live in a small house in Jersey. You know what I mean? We don't have no big mansion. We have a one-story little ranch house. My stepdad does all right, you know?
Yeah.
But
do you ever catch your parents banging?
No, my mom's going to watch this.
I'm just asking the hard questions.
She knows that you know that they banged.
She knows that you know.
I don't care.
That's anyways. How you got here.
They could do... No, my stepdad, no.
No, your parents banging, though. It's like
my
the
dad
slaughterhouse.
Before yeah, I,
like you know the slaughterhouse is out there. You know there's some nasty shit happening in there. But
are you sure,
you don't,
are you
I don't
sure she's
going to
watch this?
Yeah.
Tell us about sex with your girlfriend.
No, it's great.
What's it
what
like?
Do you want to hear about?
What kind of stuff are you into?
It's tight. That's
you're not into
tight.
Anything weird?
No, not no, no.
No, no we've had
I'm
some
not talking about this.
We won't talk. We won't talk about it.
Are you into staying in shape?
Staying in shape?
Yeah.
He's got a hot little body on.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He's chiseled. Yeah.
When I went through like the senior year thing, I would go to the gym like 5 times a week.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean? Got it.
But you don't do that anymore.
No, I don't do that anymore.
You don't work out at all?
No.
How does your body so fucking hot?
Do you keep the muscles just from riding?
Kind of. You lose any size, but you don't lose
you
like,
keep,
the
like,
strength.
The,
you know what I mean?
The strength and
the
like
girth.
The fact that you're dense muscularly.
But yeah, I'm not into that shit anymore. I just ride every day.
Right.
What kind of music you listen to these days?
Rap music.
Thug music.
Thug music.
Like who?
My current playlists.
Yeah, Playboy.
I listen to Playboy Cardi a shitload. I listen to ASAP Rocky a lot.
Hey.
I listen to... I fuck with G-Eazy.
I don't know if I can coast on that one. No, I'm not a big fan.
It's like it's more so like when I'm like chilling out, just driving or something, you know? But yeah.
It's another Eskimo brother of mine.
G-Eazy.
Oh.
That's tight.
Adam's fucked 470
That's
women.
That's not true. I wish that was a number.
I wish.
I feel so much more
I
accomplished.
Wish I fucked that many girls.
472, goddamn. That's a fucking brolic ass number. I'd make a chain that said 472. Jeez. Rock that
around. I feel like I
town.
Didn't answer. I haven't answered a bunch of shit that people that I expected.
Okay,
to
when you are Adam's age, which is 10 years. Adam's 10 years older than you. How many girls would you like to have had sex with?
See, like, these are questions I'm not answering.
Because he's got a girlfriend, so he cannot possibly say any more than he has right now, even though he knows that maybe that will happen someday.
He's a little pervert.
Is he?
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard. What do you think that the kids want to know about that we haven't asked you? I feel like we've hit on a lot of hard-hitting questions already, even though we're, like, less than 50 minutes in.
Hmm. What's a typical day for you?
Typical day. Right now?
Yep.
And you live on your own in HB?
I live with Vish.
With Vish, right. With Vish. Never mind.
Two bedroom, two bath. It's my first time ever having a roommate. When I moved here, my girl moved with me, and we had a one bedroom apartment that we truly could not afford. And
LA life.
Yeah. So, lived there for a year, spent all my money on rent.
Mm-hmm.
And she moved home. Because she just wasn't really feeling it, you know?
Right.
But then I finished the lease by myself, then moved into a different apartment, one-bedroom apartment, that I still kind of, I could afford it, but didn't really want to because it was kind of a shithole. But just living by yourself sucks, man. You come home every night and you're just like, oh, yeah, fuck. I got nobody to chat with. I got nobody to do nothing. So.
Well, you got the damn dog, so yeah. You got it.
Well, yeah, Leo, come
you
here.
Shouldn't. Advice to anybody that's moving come out here, to boy. Los Angeles, do not get a fucking dog your first 5 years here.
Come here, big boy. Come here.
Because it's just.
There the dog's is. A menace.
He's a big motherfucker.
What's up, big boy?
I would like the world to know that Tony the cat is currently locked in the bathroom with his food bowl and his litter box because yeah, this dog is scaring the shit out of him.
What's up? So, yeah, actually, I'll explain the dog situation, too. So I moved into the apartment, whatever. I didn't like it, and I was just overwhelmed with the whole L.A. traffic shit. And I like to surf, and I like to chill, and I like to drive without traffic and just go to the grocery store and park in the parking lot. You know what I'm saying? But so Valentine's Day, about, like, 6 months into – actually, about 3 months into living in Los Angeles, I was bored as fuck. And I was on Craigslist looking at dogs. And my girl was like, yeah, let's get a dog, blah, blah. So I was like, all right, go on Craigslist. I talk about it. Call my mom. My mom's like, yeah, don't do it. Call my stepdad. He's like, that's the worst idea I've ever heard. I'm like, you know what? Fuck it. I go to Barstow and I pick this guy up.
Barstow.
Oh,
what's that, like a two-hour drive?
Yeah. It was like an hour and 45-minute drive, whatever. Met this sketchy-ass dude in a 7-Eleven parking lot. He opens the front door of his shady-ass Honda Civic and puts out three puppies on the pavement. And he's just like, which one do you want? And I was just like, oh, fuck, what? You know what I mean? Sit down on the ground. This dumbass was the first one to come up to me, and I was just like, this one. So I got the dog. It was cool as fuck because I would go ride all day. My girl would come home from work, and she would take care of the dog, walk the dog, blah, blah, blah. Now, my life is all types of fucked up because I can't go on trips. And if I do go on trips, I have to figure out who's going to watch the dog.
Yeah, well, it must be such a pain in the ass.
Which is cool. Well, which I, like, Vish said he was down to help me out a little bit, like walking him if I was out riding late or whatever, blah, blah, blah. But then I was like, when I go on trips, you're most likely going to be on
the trip.
So I got to figure that out still, yeah. But everything I do, if I'm out, if I leave before 9 a.m. and come back past 8 p.m., it's a nightmare.
Yeah.
Eats everything in the crib, fucks everything up. Yep. So life advice.
I know a couple people in HB. I'll be able to help you out a little bit with that.
Life advice, do not get a dog before you're settled down.
Yeah.
Very true.
Duh. But at the same time, he's my dude. And
I just thought of a really iconic trick that we probably should talk about. Yeah. Ice bar down Hollywood High. What the fuck made you think that you could do that? And it was supposed to be in a line. Let's talk about that.
All right. So and that was 3 days planned before. Out. No. This was not planned.
Oh, really? Okay.
3 days.
This wasn't when you lived here, though. You were coming out on trips at the time.
I think I lived here.
Really?
Oh. Yeah, no, you lived here.
Did I? Yeah, no, I did live here. I did live here. Yeah, I lived here.
Okay.
So that happened. We were just, like, riding Hollywood High, blah, blah, blah. I'm pretty sure we were. I'm not sure, to be honest. I think I went there to film a line, and the line was supposed to. Well, yeah. Actually, yeah.
How do I remember this better than you? Nollie three off the roof, 180 whip, and then you were supposed to do ice bar, but then you ended up crooking the line.
Tried it from like, I'd say like 3 to dark.
Right.
Didn't get it.
Just what? Pussying out on the bar?
Pussying out on the bar. But then like the Nolly 3 and the 180, like I would have kept going, but right. It got dark. And I was just like, the Nolly 3 was like probably like a 7-foot drop or something. So it was just like boom. And then it was right into a 180 whip where I was just like taking all my energy. And then I was trying to ice bar.
That is crazy. That's a workout right there.
And then I was like, fuck it. I didn't get it. And the next day, I was like, yo, I still don't have an ender for this video. And
right.
Like, I found somebody, Miles, told me that I was going to have the last part in the video. And I was like, fuck, dude, I can't end it on this dumbass line. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Like, I needed to do kind of something. And so we went back the next day at like 4. We snipped it was like locked up, like chained up. Yeah. The bike racks were at the bottom. Brenner came through. I think it was Brenner. Snipped the locks on the bottom of that rail, and I tried it for like an hour. I did the Nolly 3. Was the clip at nighttime?
The one you pulled? I don't think so. Or was it? I don't think so. I don't.
Okay, so actually I was wrong. The night that it got dark, Tony came through with the generator, and I tried it for like another hour, and I couldn't do it just because I was like dead.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I couldn't hold on anymore. My fucking ankles were hurting from the 180 whip. And I didn't do it. Came out the next day at 3 o'clock, snipped the thing. I tried the line for like probably like 30 minutes, 40 minutes, and I was like, dude, fuck, I cannot do this. You know, like I could have, but I was like, I'm not risking not getting the clip again. So I did the Nolly 3 180 whip in the crook just to like get a clip.
Get something. Yeah,
yeah. And then I just tried the ice bar for like probably an hour.
And got one.
First one I threw, yeah. It just took me for a while to like sling them.
What's it like doing a fucking hot bair out of that? An ice pick on a fucking 18 stair rail.
So fast.
Yeah.
The rail is just steep as fuck, and it's like at the bottom, it's just like, it's one of those rails that kind of, well, mad people grind it, whatever, but it like, it's kind of like a hard landing when you hit the ground. You know what I mean? It's not like just like chilling.
It's steep.
You know what I mean? It's just like boom. But there was like a lot of times where I like twitched, and like if I would have thrown it, I wouldn't have caught the bars. You know what I'm saying? But the one that I like popped, I like just knew. And like if you watch the video, bro, my hands land as the bars hit the ground, and I like swerve because my hands were like, you know what I mean? But
Is it scary for you sessioning a fucking 18 stair rail at this point, or is it just whatever?
I picked that rail probably like 300 times.
And you never like took a bad fall or anything?
No.
See, that's what's crazy though, is that he's got it. He's in the zone. Yeah.
I had one sketchy one where I like did an ice pick and my front wheel was over the other side and it was like about to drop and I like somehow held it up and just manned it.
What does scare you on your bike?
Everything.
What do you mean? Like what is the kind of stuff that you like to do? But this, do you like doing like a big ass gap that is gonna scare you, or do you stay away from
it? Depends. It depends like what kind of mood I'm in, or if I think about it. You know what I mean? Like if I'm like standing in front of something kind of crazy and I think about getting hurt, I'm not doing it.
Right.
You know what I mean? But if I just do it and I'm like, I got this, put my headphones in and just do it, then it's over and done with. But if I like think like, all right, I could fucking nose case this and flip over and smash my teeth, no, I'm not doing it.
Right.
But I always have it kind of in the back of my head, like you can get hurt doing anything, but I usually don't do something unless I know I can do it.
Right.
You know what I mean? Or something that I see like, right there, you know what I mean? Like I'm like iffy, but it's like right there. You know what I mean? Like the last clip in my video, in the cult video, I just went there. Just
what was it again? I forget.
Up rail.
Oh right, yeah.
Like when we pulled up to the rail, I was just like, all right, I'm just gonna switch grind up just to whip, like for a clip. You know what I mean? And I like did it not pretty easily. It took me a couple tries, but I got it pretty quickly and like wasn't tired, wasn't anything. And I was like, fuck, dude, I think I can 180 whip out of this. And I was like, I didn't know I could do it, but it was just like. I was like, I think I can.
But you have probably done like feeble 180 whip on an up ledge at a skate park, no?
I've never done any type of grind to 180 whip.
Really?
Yeah.
Holy fuck.
How many stairs was it?
I think like 20? Is it 20?
20. 18. Switch grind.
18. 18. Whatever. Crazy. Yeah.
It's the same one that like Devin Smiley did.
Did the hard bar.
Up the hard bar, yeah.
And then, yeah, DeMarcus went up to Nolly bar.
True.
But yeah.
Hey, are you friends with Gary Reynolds?
Yeah. Now, yeah.
Yeah? But were you not at a certain point?
I think growing up, he didn't really like me. I don't. I hope he likes me now, but yeah, I think he does. But growing up, I think he didn't really like me just because I copied him so much.
Did you copy him?
Yeah, like
riding wise or what?
Everything.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
You'd have the striped bike?
No, I never. I don't think I never did the striped bike. Just
you were too late for
that.
No.
Definitely not too late.
Okay.
But I just didn't take it. I just couldn't do that. I mean, I probably wanted to, but I just couldn't.
But you know what's funny? Stevie had it, but it was only because Jeff Martin did it to his bike.
Yeah. The big thing that I used to copy, like anybody I was feeling, was sticker placement.
Yeah.
I used to run the same stickers in the same place, and I was like, yeah, my bike looks like his. You know what I'm saying? But I don't like think any of that shit's bad, you know what I mean? Because when kids copy me now or somebody's like, oh, this kid's like your twin or something, I'm like, tight, bro. Like,
yeah, you're inspiring them. Yeah, that's the coolest thing in the world.
And I was just a dickhead, so maybe that's why I didn't like it.
That is a fact.
That's definitely it. Maybe because I copied him, maybe because I'm a dickhead, but I don't think he really liked me growing up, but I think everything's cool now. You know,
but how do
every
you,
time I see him, we talk.
A lot of people always say that you're like either the second rider below him, or that you're some would even say better than him. How does that feel? Or what do you think of that?
No, not even close. No,
really,
not even close.
You
bro.
Don't think you belong in the?
No,
you don't think.
I mean, I don't think that I don't belong, but better or near him, no.
What is he way better at than you are, though? Like,
everything.
What kind of stuff does he do that you can never
everything.
Do?
He has, bro, I just, in the back of my head, I just know that he's 5 years ahead of everyone.
Yeah.
And he's just sitting on clips that just, like, people are learning now, but he filmed last year.
But you know of clips that he
no,
has that
no,
are...
No, but it's just apparent as fuck.
Yeah.
It's just
yeah.
Like, and I'll just hear shit from maybe like Ty or like somebody over talking and I'm just like, oh my God.
It always is like that though, because there's been so many tricks over the years that I heard about Garrett doing and then never saw him actually do it. Because it became like normal or at least some other people doing it, you know?
He's never dropped a video that people don't trip over for like a month.
Yeah.
At least two months, a year.
Every single time
he
puts anything
out. It's not. And if you watch, you can see like from bikes and shit that some of the shit is old.
Yeah.
But I think you and Garrett are very similar in that any filmer can go out with you and get content. It's not like you're never going to struggle for content because you're so dialed, you know, like, and that's just how you ride.
We haven't seen a real Garrett part in a while, though, because that Red Bull section was dope, but it wasn't like the level of effort that he put into Deadline and Fiend, in my opinion.
Right.
Yeah.
So, like, the next thing he puts out will probably be, like, super offensive.
Yeah. Yeah, totally.
Who do you like to watch ride?
Yeah.
Lately, I really like to watch Alex Kennedy ride. Mm. Growing up, I was like a huge fan of Kevin Corrali.
Really?
Yeah. I used to think like his outfits were always on point, his riding was always on point.
You guys are both a couple of little swag fags.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I was really into Corrali. I was really into JJ. But lately, I like watching Alex Kennedy. I like watching Devin ride. I like watching Andrew Castaneda ride.
But a lot of people think that BMX is kind of fucked up or crazy right now because the level of riding at the top pro level is so unbelievable, and it's so tech, and some people think it's kind of unrelatable and stuff. Do you love it? Do you love just, like, how fucking insane the progression is in BMX?
I love figuring shit out for myself and, like, just seeing what you could do.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, I'll see somebody do something, and I'll be like, fuck, but you can do that here or with this or something. You know what I mean? And it's like, it's just... God, Leo, come on.
Meme.
What's he doing?
Meme.
Dude,
definitely a meme.
We got a slow-mo. Adam getting scared right there. Holy shit. Holy
Hey, you stupid-ass dog.
Shit.
We're talking about progression over here. You had to go and scare me.
He scared the fuck out of me.
Scared the piss out of me.
Please.
Leo. Not necessarily hold him. Just keep an eye on the person.
God damn.
But what was it? What were we talking about?
Just talking about Cap is just dying.
Dude, I
like
feel like
scared.
I'm doing like an interview or fucking something for school, dude.
Really?
I used to, bro,
yeah,
I used
this is great. This is very, very.
You think this is a good interview?
Oh, it's so good. Yeah.
Really?
For the last 2 months, I've been saying, "Hey, let's do this," and then we knew about the cult thing before everybody else, so we couldn't let it go. Like, that's why we were waiting because there was a chance. Like, you weren't gonna do the interview because you were on the verge of getting picked up.
I just didn't. I didn't want to honestly like come in here. Piss a bunch of people off, say a bunch of dumbass shit.
I don't think you said anything that would piss anybody off.
You've filled your quota of saying dumb shit in your career.
Maybe stranger a little bit, but even then, you kept it pretty PC.
The stranger shit, I appreciate everything you've done for me, and I just don't think that it was a place for me to be for a long period of time. Mm. You know what I mean? I feel like it was what it was, and that's it. And now, from this point on, I don't want to fuck with anybody that I can't see myself being with 10 years from now.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's like, cool. I don't want the $500 check from fucking some like a cracker company or something. You know what I mean? I don't care.
I think that people are going to be happy that we actually talked about the riding a good amount. Question, if you play Stevie in a game of bike again, is there any chance of you losing?
Me?
Yeah.
No.
You got it?
I got it, 100%. I'm not even being a dick, but come on.
Right. Yeah. I mean, it was pretty good in the other one.
He tried to sting me with a bunch of dumbass shit, and I was like, all right, we're going to play that was, like that. It was weird. Let's play like that then.
Yeah. So then you did all the railroad stuff.
I don't ever want to play a game of bike again. How about that?
Really?
It's dumb as hell.
We played today.
But so what?
That was, we were all having fun at HP.
But so when you play a game of bike, though, is it, do you consider it like him doing like the whip to frame stand or whatever?
Stupid.
Were you not going to do the railroad stuff?
I wasn't going to do any of that. Like, right. If you noticed my first tricks that I didn't land,
yeah,
I was like doing normalized shit. Like, I did a bar spin. I did like a bar to pegs. I tried a bar pegs over hard 180. I did like a predator. I was going to do a predator.
But you know, Stevie's not going to do bar pegs over hard.
Yeah, but that's reasonable.
It's still a reasonable trick.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, a tail whip to frame stand?
Yeah, I agree. That was corny.
Rocket ride to tail whip?
Yeah, that's...
Like, bro, I've never even thought of that shit.
Yeah, exactly, because that's the weird thing. A game of bike is such a gentleman's game, because it's like...
And he thought he was going to have me on, like, a lot of the shit that he did, and he did. I don't think he expected that I was going to do some shit. Like,
really?
Like, I've never done a switch 180 switch bar in my entire life.
Really?
And he did that, and I was like, fuck. And then I just somehow... made it happen.
Were you surprised that you got that?
Yeah, 100%. And then, like, the three up off the ledge, I, like, thought that I could do it, but I was like, fuck, I don't know.
Yeah.
And then I ended up doing it. The switch up I thought I could do, and I didn't do it.
But now you're a three up boss because you did that one in the fucking cult video off that loading dock, which was pretty ridiculous.
Yeah, that was...
Was that inspired by the game of bike?
No.
No?
That was just a joke, and then Dak told me to do it, and I did it.
So you were surprised that you could...
I wasn't surprised I could do it, but I just went there and I was like, bro, I could probably three up off this. And then Dak was like, are you fucking kidding me? Do it. And I was like, okay. And we filmed it.
God, I wish I had done more research. I wish I had known that we were doing this interview, because I would have fucking looked up more tricks that we could have talked about. But hey, I think this has been pretty legit. You said you only wanted to do a half hour. Here we are at over an hour.
I'm ready to keep talking. No, I'm just
kidding. But I don't know.
We'd love to have you come back, too.
Did I piss anyone off yet?
I don't think so.
Fuck Rodeo Peanut.
Piss me off with that dog.
Fuck you.
Scared the shit out of
me. I drove him here to do the other interview. And
so this is all a big surprise.
I'm doing an interview.
You're the stand-in for Jamie Bestwick.
Complain about the fucking dog.
Well, I got my cat cooped up in the bathroom. I feel bad for him.
You leave the fucking cat, and your cat hasn't left his store in 4 years.
Yeah, but he's in the bathroom. He's in like a closet.
He doesn't like being in there.
It's been 2 years.
Leo, come here, bud. Come on. Come say what's up.
I'm very happy about this.
Come here. Come here. Over here.
I just think it's funny that you're a stand-in for Jamie Bestwick.
He's my nigga, too. Come on.
He had to come pick up some further gear at the fashion district.
So, what, you just own the N-word now, huh? You don't mind saying it?
No.
He called me the N-word in a stranger video.
Exactly, and I thought that people were really going to lose it. There was a Rodeo Peanut about it, but there wasn't that much blowback from it.
Well,
I
am.
He's got separation anxiety, bro. He's
real bad.
Oh,
he's a real hog for attention, isn't he?
Yep.
Yeah, that's cool. Tony's the same way.
But
you're still cool with everybody at V-Block? You're still rocking the trip.
Yeah.
That's the only other clothing line I see you wear besides Further.
Yeah. I rock a lot of blank tees. I rock trip stuff. I rock my own stuff. And rock some band stuff.
Yeah.
I rock cult t-shirts.
Are you optimistic about ever getting like a dope sneaker deal or a dope energy drink
thing? I wouldn't
rock
for anybody about Vans.
Really?
Yeah. And Batters has been hooking me up lately, which is super.
Shout out to Batters.
Super cool. Shout out to Batters. Yeah.
How do you feel about the strength of the BMX industry? Are we all fucked?
I don't really care.
Yeah, it's whatever.
Not necessarily backbone, but like I started Further, so it's something that I can do after I ride bikes. You know what I mean? After my bike riding shit's done, and just to like not even just make money, but like more so like just something that I'm passionate about. You know what I mean? I feel like that's something. Like, I'm not into fashion now, really. Like, I am, and I follow as much as I can aside from riding and shit, but I feel like when I'm done riding and I can actually be, like, trying to do that type of shit.
You'll have, like, a foundation for it.
Exactly, yeah. You know what I mean? Because
most brands, it's, like, really hard for a brand to take off within the first couple years.
And I didn't even expect that, you know what I mean? And honestly, I sell shit to hella girls.
Really?
Girls. Like, I have a lot, but I'd say, like, 50% of my customers are girls.
Do you make girl sizes or anything?
No, but they buy hats. Like a motherfucker, like the dad caps.
You put the hats on first, so like a little bit of your hair goes in with them. Could be something to think about.
Possibly. That could be good. Girls get turned on by that. Kids love when they get a shirt and it's got a little bit of Tony fur on it.
Okay.
That happens.
But other than that, rock trip shit.
Question though, are you ever going to be a webisode guy?
Am I gonna make this?
So like everybody does in BMX and the YouTube
tell
game.
Them, tell them our plan. Tell them our plan.
Catfish. Okay, Catfish.
Sean Ricany YouTube channel. I could see you cracking 100K in 2 months.
How really? About this? This is what
you
I
really
told.
Think so?
Scotty Kramer kills it. Well, he's not killing it, but he's going for it. Building.
We'll get your advice
Chris
on this.
Chris Kyle's doing good.
The other day, he went. Now that he lives fucking 3 minutes from me, I
you
was
live
like,
with a filmer.
I was like, let's do Catfish and Sean Ricany webisodes. People will tune in for the antics, my
so
antics,
easy, yeah.
and his. Riding, we could do it.
I know you guys neither. You know how to use a camera, but I'm sure you could figure it out.
I know how to use a camera.
I know how to use a camera.
Okay. You're a good filmer?
I was an HMC owner.
You were? What happened? You sell it for pills?
I couldn't pay rent 1 month and I sold it.
Yeah, I don't do it. Yeah.
I sold a lot of shit. A lot of shit paying rent.
I bought it. I have an HMC that I might have bought from someone who was selling it for pills.
Nice.
If I had to guess, you could probably guess too. Well, you're a good filmer.
Nah, I'm not a good filmer.
Well, you can film a little bit. I think you two doing webisodes together.
I film Grant's clip in my edit.
You got to just be the webisode presence in the OC because it would be dope to have Biz in there when Bizzle inevitably moves back.
The common kids.
Well, they act like webisode haters. So.
No, they do their own thing. I'm not getting involved with them.
You get involved with me, we'll do it ourselves.
You hate the comic crew?
No, not at all.
You just don't know them that well?
I've been around them a bit more, like at bands and stuff, and I don't mind them at all. I'm friendly with them. I talk to them.
But they've hated on the internet before, right?
About me?
Have they? Probably, right?
I think maybe, but they don't say anything now when they say what's up.
I'll find that out.
You'll find out.
They're good.
You're the Louis Farrakhan of those.
Francis talks well about me on Twitter all the time.
Francis talks about everybody. Francis is the Donald Trump of BMX.
Yeah, Francis is voting for Donald Trump, so we got to worry about that.
I like that. I like that about him. It's very on brand
just
for
keep
him.
Winking at you.
Yeah, what is that? You are sus beyond belief.
I'm into it.
Wow. All right.
Well, we
Speaking
did it.
Speaking of Corrali,
the Sean Ricany.
There he is.
What are we talking about?
We just got the Corrali like, dude.
If I couldn't, you have your likes turned on. You have your notifications on.
No, it's
on?
Just from people that I follow.
Yeah, I don't fuck with that either.
Damn,
dude. I have no notifications for anything.
Also, let it be known that on the way up here, Sean said, "I'm not doing a TCU TV. I want a
no
jumper. I want to do a no jumper.
Change the fucking sign, dude."
Well, that is a funny thing is that now it's like, oh, you could be on like the no jumper ones seem like they get more views on average. But I do want to do that at some point. It would be dope.
No
to, like,
jumper definitely
have BMXers
gets
on
more
no jumper.
Gets no
we
jumper gets
the
girls.
The whole
There's
time
way more
jumper.
Girls that follow that watch no.
Oh,
jumpers.
The percentage is still so bad on YouTube though. It's like 9% girls.
How far are you going to chop this down?
Nothing.
You're leaving the whole thing around. Yeah. What time? What's the time?
Talk shit on somebody. 10, you want to talk roughly. Shit on somebody?
Sure.
Who do you want to give us somebody?
Yeah, who do you hate?
Who do I hate? Oh, fuck.
Donald Trump.
No.
No? Wow.
Who do I hate?
Has anyone crossed you? I've had many people cross me in my time. I don't ever let it go.
Who do I hate? I don't even... Bro, that's fucked because I can't even answer that question.
Has anyone ever fucked you over?
Yeah. I'm not going to get into this. That, actually, yeah. There's a couple kids from home that have fucked me over.
Fuck those kids.
What, you trusted them with money or something?
Just as friends.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And I'm not going to get into names, but they know who they are.
Sketchy Jersey kids.
Sketchy Jersey kids, yeah.
Could you ever move back to Jersey?
Fuck no.
Just what, the weather or what?
Resounding fuck no.
Just everything. Yeah, I mean, it's just not where I ever want to be.
Yeah.
The type of people that are around are just not the type of people I want to be around. I don't like the whole... So, like, Jersey's mindset is go to school, go to college, get a career.
Yeah, don't tap the table.
Go to school, go to college,
right.
Get a job, get a house, have a family, die in the house.
That doesn't appeal to you?
No.
You're not looking forward to a family and stuff?
No, not really.
Well, you're very young, so
I mean, one day, sure, but not.
Definitely not the plans
not
right
going
now.
Going back to Jersey, I'll tell you that. Unless, well,
but
I
it's
mean,
home, you know. You enjoy
home.
Going
yeah, no,
home.
Home.
You enjoy seeing the family.
I don't mind it, but anybody that I associate with from there are just people that I don't talk to for months at a time or whatever, and it's like
not everybody, but there's
not everybody. Okay, so I have
Chris Christie. He's cool.
Chris Christie, who's that?
The governor.
Oh, I don't even know who the fuck that is. But I got a group chat.
For president for a while.
If you ain't in this group chat right here, let me see.
I'm not in that group text.
You're not in it.
What is the group text?
Name.
Is this
names.
Like the D-Block group chat?
No. This is a group chat from home.
This is the Jersey group chat.
Jersey group chat. Hold on.
I want names.
Where the fuck is it?
Is Augie in this?
No. This is like Dom, Andrew, Kevin. Pootie Grimace is called Bike Life.
A Bike Life.
Bike
Sean
Life
Venerable,
is
Kevin Ortiz, Kyle, Dom.
Bike
Andrew.
Life.
Let's see.
That's like the trashy ass kind of name
me the last
that
photo in your group text.
Kids in Jersey would give a group chat
you don't
a name
have to
like
show the camera.
Bike
just
life.
Show me.
That's a corny name.
I can't even
switch that.
I'll show you.
Just show me down here.
Change it from Bike Life to M22 Sucks.
I sent.
No, just the last one. I want to see the last one.
Let's wrap
set.
This up. This we're gonna
we
draw
might,
this out.
We might
okay,
break.
Okay, all right, we're not doing this. But yeah, that's it. I'm not moving back to Jersey. No,
no.
I just don't fuck.
We don't want you to.
I don't fuck with the shady people. I like the kids that I grew up with and are still my friends. Cool. The kids that I cut off, and if I don't talk to you anymore, go fuck yourself.
That's nice. You sounded like fucking Jay Wow. All right.
Well,
for a second.
let's end this on a positive note. Thank yous.
Shout out to Colt.
Shout out to Colt.
Shout out to Further Brand.
Shout out to
Further
Mom,
Brand.
Moms.
Shout out to The Block. Shout out to...
The Block.
The family.
My family for all the support over the years. Shout out to Sunglass Company, Blenders, Eyewear.
You're going to get a...
Shout out to the homies out over at Ithaca.
You're going to get a part sponsor in 2016?
No, I don't want a part sponsor.
You don't want one?
Mm-mm.
Why? Because Colts holds it down?
Yeah, definitely. I would rather focus on one brand and put my full attention towards something that I fully am into rather than... Just have two things and just
Robbie doesn't like people going off and getting part sponsors anyway.
I don't necessarily think he doesn't like it. I don't think
well, Colt makes everything.
Colt makes everything for one, and just
Robbie likes a full.
Yeah,
you
Colt,
know, he like
got
I, think, I don't think he's ever really. I
yeah.
mean, obviously some of his Robbies
I mean,
have part sponsors,
there
but
there was I probably the only parts company I'd probably ever ride for is like Eclaw or something. You know,
right.
Like that brand I think is cool as fuck.
Good vibe.
Their team's dope,
yeah.
But. Even if that, I think I would just stay with Colt, to be honest. I'm just, like, super into it and shit, you know?
Yeah. Well, hey, Sean, thanks a shitload for coming on the
Mr.
podcast. It's really amazing.
Thank you very
yeah.
much.
I love
ow!
It.
Ow! You hear that snap?
That's a nice shirt.
Thank
he
you very
him.
Much. I'd like to thank him for...
when are we going to carry some shit in the store? Oh,
can I get a further shirt? And, I mean, we're down to stock it. Yeah, it's fine.
Yeah, you're not, though. Because
why?
You say that, but Alfredo says otherwise.
Well, okay.
Ooh,
I'll have
to
speak to my business associate.
Here.
When this comes out and he gets called out, he's going to know.
Thank you for watching.
Actually,
you
I don't
guys
know if he said
watching.
Otherwise, but he said it was confrontation or something.
You have been watching TCU TV.
Oh, competition.
Please follow
competition.
My good
yeah.
friend, Adam Grand Mason. Follow... Just popped out.
Stop tapping people's nuts
that's
and stuff. That,
let
that's
us finish.
Worst.
We're can I finish
the main
working?
Thing I don't like
can
about you is that you smack me in the
can
nuts when I see you at the bar.
Long.
What is that?
All day
so
long.
So annoying.
I don't have an idea.
Grabs
to go
my
to the bar
dick.
Anymore.
All he does is just grab me.
That's good news to
dick.
Me. I could go to the bar and not
so,
get my dick
guys,
touched.
Again, thanks to Sean Ricany for doing the TCU TV. This is Big Leo.
This dog's a menace.
Follow us on Facebook. Follow us on Instagram. Follow me on Instagram, Catfish versus Thug. Adam22.
Jamie Bestwick interview coming one day.
That's right. Jamie Bestwick coming soon. Thank you, Sean Ricany.
On the Ducati.
This is the TCU TV. Boobity boppa doo boppa ski bop bop. Come up TV.
You have to.
We'll put out some more.
No, you're not.
Sure.
Are you serious?
No, you're right.
It's so good.
Boom.
Can you just send it before you...